Hey, what's up, y'all? It's your girl, Alexis, and welcome to Res Youth TV. We are so excited to have you here with us on today. Did you have a good week? Because I sure enough did. If you didn't, that's okay, because it's about to get better. We have a dope service in store for you. Some praise and worship, some challenges that might get a little messy, and of course, a word just for you. I'm gonna go ahead and bless us with a word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come before you, God, once again saying thank you. Boy, starting off a prayer saying thank you, God, because you didn't have to do it, God. You didn't have to get us here safely. You didn't have to wake us up another day, God. You didn't have to keep us from the virus. You didn't have to, God, but you did, God. You have kept us, God. You have covered us during these crazy times, God. And we know that these are the times that you said, God, that you are here, you are near to come, God. You said that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that at the name of Jesus, God, you will live forever. You are amazing, God. I love you. We love you, God. And we just pray for Pastor Shelby on today for this word that is to come. We thank you for Pastor Shepherd leading this flock, God. We thank you for everybody behind the scenes, God, the praise and worship team, God. We thank you for everything that you are doing. You have not yet done, God, and even saying, we say thank you for saying no, God, because it's not that time, God, or it's not for us. So we want to say thank you one more time. Thank you for this word that's about to go forth, God. Bless it in your name. In Jesus' name I pray, everybody say amen. Now let's get some praise and worship time.
To illuminate the soul, light shines bright everywhere we go.
Hi guys, it's your girl Alexis, and today we have the most fantastic game in store for you. Now today what we're going to be doing is we're going to play a little game. It's called Cheeto Head. Who knew, right? So what we're going to be doing is the opponents, we have two teams, two great lovely people that decided to be our volunteers. The objective of the game is to get as many Cheetos on the caps as possible, but they're going to do it backwards. Let's see how this ends. Are y'all ready? Yeah. I can't hear you. What'd you say? Oh, okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let me get your legs from. Hold on. And go. Oh, got one. One. I thought you were not supposed to look. Go, Cheeto Head. Go, go, go. Oh, a grease lightning. Oh, 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 oh. This is for every problem who had a problem with her. It's okay. I got you. Right here. I won't mess you up. One, ding, 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 ding. Ah. Let's see who won the Cheeto toss. Let's count over here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. 12 disciples. All right, here we go. We'll count that one. That's one. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Ding, 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 ding. We have a winner. Yay. Woo!
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to our very first youth service here on Res Youth TV. Man, I am so excited. This has been a day that we've been waiting for some time, and it is finally here. This pandemic has caused us to do things differently. We've connected with you guys on Zoom and Instagram, so forth and so on, but we wanted to give you guys your very own service to connect with you this way through our YouTube page here on Res Youth TV. And so hopefully you've had a great time through the service thus far. You've enjoyed the music, some of the challenges, and hopefully we have a word for you too from our God. Please turn with me to Luke chapter 19. Luke chapter 19, your Bible or your Bible app. And today we're going to read verses 1 through 4. 1 through 4. And it reads, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. There was a man there by the name of Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but because he was short, he could not see over the crowd. And so he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming that way. And so for the next 3 weeks, we're going to begin a series today entitled It Hits Different. It hits different. Now, most of you know what I mean when I say that. But for those of you that don't, it simply means that you have now experienced something in a different way, in a unique way, in a way you've never experienced it before, or you might not have experienced otherwise. It hits different. So let me give you some examples. Maybe you have had a chicken sandwich from Chick-fil-A before, but when KFC came out with their chicken sandwich, you said, I gotta go try it. And the minute you bit into it, you're like, this hits different. Maybe you heard a song before and you liked it. You were bumping it in your brand new Beats, but then they came out with the remix and Little Baby was featured on it. You were like, oh, this remix, it hits different. And we all have those friends. We all have different types of friends. We have some friends that we talk to every now and again, but then we have those friends that we can talk to. Maybe we haven't talked to in months, but every single time we get on the phone, we catch up like nothing ever happened, because those relationships, what? They hit different. And that's exactly what Res Youth TV, this youth service, is all about. Hopefully, it hits different. Not because it's online versus being in the building, or being on YouTube versus being on Zoom, but this is all about you not experiencing church in a different way, or in a unique way, or in a way you've never experienced before. But this is about you experiencing Jesus in a way you never have before. And it just so happens that our main character for today's message, Zacchaeus, was able to do just that as well. But how? I'm so glad you asked. For Zacchaeus, it only hit different because he was persistent. It only hit different because he was persistent. Matter of fact, type that in the comments. That's the title of today's message in our series, It Hits Different. It hits different when you're persistent. Persistent. You ever met someone and in the moment they seem cool, the conversation that you're having goes relatively well, for the most part y'all are vibing, and so out of the kindness of your heart you give them your phone number to continue their relationship, and now this person texts, calls, or FaceTimes you all the time. No matter how many times you've left them on read, hey man, did you get my message? Hey, call me back when you get a chance. I sent you a message yesterday, did you get it? Why is your phone always off? They are what? Persistent. You ever had someone come to your door trying to sell something? Or maybe you overheard someone trying to sell something to your parents. And even though you tell them off top, hey man, I'm not interested, they still keep trying to talk to you, to convince you of the benefits of their product. And then after you tell them no again, they try to act like them giving you a discount will cause you to buy it. Persistence. Maybe you ever wanted something, or you wanted to go somewhere really bad. I mean, two of your best friends invited you to the party of the year, or all of your other friends have something, and whatever it is, you don't have, and you do not want to be the one that's left out of the conversation, and so you ask your mom for it or to go, and she says no. So then you go and ask your dad, and he says, what'd your mom say? And so now you resort to what? Begging and pleading, giving every reason as to why you gotta go or why you gotta have this. Persistence. What would happen if we were as persistent as the annoying friend, as persistent as the salesman, as persistent as we are with our parents when it came to our pursuit of a relationship with Jesus Christ? I bet it might hit a little different. Persistence literally means continuing in a course of action in spite of difficulty or opposition. And in our text for today, that's exactly what Zacchaeus did. He pushed past some obstacles in the way of him seeing Jesus, what? Clearly. Some obstacles that I think, if we look closely, might be in our way as well. For number one, he had to push past what he'd been given. He had to push past what he'd been given. The text says in verse 3 that he wanted to see Jesus, but he could not, being that he was what? Short. Did Zacchaeus ask to be short? No. For those of you who are vertically challenged, do you ask to be short? I think not. In fact, I don't know too many people who have that at the top of their wish list. But that was the card that he was dealt. And many of us, when we look in the mirror or sit around the dinner table during the holidays, we look and see things or people that we did not choose. And if we had our way, maybe wouldn't have chosen, if we're honest, because of the challenges that come with them. You didn't ask to be short. You didn't ask to have bad skin. You didn't ask to have black skin, for your teeth not to be perfectly straight for that brother or sister. You didn't ask for a strict mom or a parent who's not around, but those are the cards that we've been dealt. And if we're not careful, we'll allow the limitations of what we've been given to be all we ever got, when that doesn't have to be the case. Zacchaeus said, I'm short. I can't see. So what? I'm not going to complain about it, but instead I'm going to what? Do something about it. And so I want to challenge you tonight to do things that most short people would never be able to do, to do things that people don't expect people from your racial background to do. Don't be another statistic that most kids with your family makeup are, but instead break the cycle, beat the odds, defy logic. Make sure when people see you, regardless of what you or your family looks like, it what? Hits different. So number two, not only did he have to push past what he'd been given, but he also had to persistently push past what he had attained. He had to push past what he had attained. You see, given is what someone else gave to you. But attained are those things that you worked hard for and have given yourself, or so we think. For in verse 2, from our text, it tells us that Zacchaeus was a tax collector. But not just any tax collector, y'all, but the what? The chief tax collector. And he was what? Rich. Y'all, he had made it. Mama, I made it, right? At the top of his field, making bank. For what reason does he now need to persistently pursue Jesus, right? His prayers have already been answered. And this may or may not be you, but for some of us, that is our mentality. We do this Christian thing because of what we believe we can get out of it. That if I'm a Christian, I now have this genie that I can go to when I want to or need to. And so we say, genie Jesus, bless me, bless me, bless me. And the minute we've gotten what we've prayed for, we put the lamp back on the shelf until it's time for our next wish. No longer what? Persistent. And some of you aspire to be singers and athletes and gamers and equestrians and business owners, and you will pray your whole life to get there. And when God finally blesses you to make it, then what? Do I just lose all persistence now that I've attained everything I've ever wanted or everything that society says I should have? No. We have to get to the place where we stay hungry for God, where the only thing that truly satisfies me is him, where even in the moments I do get to see and spend time with him, that's not even enough. But each and every time I what? Persistently want more and more and more and more. Because when you stop worrying about all the things you can possibly attain on earth and persistently focus on attaining a deeper relationship with him, it hits different. So Zacchaeus didn't let what he'd been given, the cards he was dealt, stop him from being persistent. He didn't let his accomplishments or status stop his persistent pursuit. And lastly, he persistently pushed past where he was in the moment to get to where he believed God was going to be. He persistently pushed past where he was in the moment. Verse 3 in our text, it says that he could not see because of the crowd. And so verse 4, he ran ahead of the crowd and climbed the sycamore tree so that he could what? See Jesus. Now, if Beyonce showed up to praise in the park at Resurrection, and there was a big old crowd, you might ask to get on someone's shoulders. You might ask someone to lift you up. You might go get a chair and stand on it. You might even stand on the top of the car, but ain't too many of us about to climb no trees. In fact, I don't even know how to. But that shows you just how persistent Zacchaeus was. The Message version of this verse for today said that he was what? Desperately. He desperately wanted to see who Jesus was. Why? Because he had heard about him. Right outside the city, if you read a couple verses before Luke chapter 19, he had just given sight to a blind man. And so, of course, everybody and their mama was talking about it. And a lot of us who are watching, a lot of us, we've heard a lot about Jesus, right? From sitting in church or on Zoom or Instagram or even on YouTube or listening to our parents or grandparents, but have yet to see him for ourselves. Let me say that part again. Somebody say that part, right? Zacchaeus said, I've heard about him, but hearing about him is one thing. But seeing him for myself, that's going to hit different. I've got to put my own eyes on him. I've got to get past where I am so I can see him what? Clearly. I could stay on this level, and I can't really see him on the level that I'm at. I could stay down here with everybody else and force myself amongst the crowd and maybe get a glimpse of him. But I don't want to settle for that. I want this to what? Hit different. And so my question for you this evening is, what are you settling for with God? In order to experience him in a way that you never have before, you got to pursue him like you never have before. But if you want what everybody else got, then you do what everybody else is doing. But if you want to be different, if you want it to hit different, if you want your own personal relationship with God, then you got to be persistent in your pursuit of him, regardless of what or who is in your way. Because the Bible says in Hebrews 11 and 6 that God is a rewarder of those who what? Diligently or persistently seek him. And I'm not talking about a pat on the back or a sticker on the wall that you used to get in kindergarten, or an e-gift card that Miss Alexis sends to you, or a Christmas gift that you might get in a couple months. No, pursue him with your whole heart, because of a reward from Jesus, it hits different. God bless you and God keep you.
Students, join us for Youth Bible Study on Tuesday, November 9th at 7 p.m. Join us on Zoom as we enjoy each other, ice cream, and the Lord. Oh, and another cool thing. Join us tomorrow at 2 p.m. as we go over what's been happening in our lives and just what's been happening in the world. So make sure to be there and get the link. We have two groups, one for middle school and high school students. So get the link and we'll see you there. And of course, if you enjoyed today's service, please meet us right here on YouTube on next Saturday, I bet, at 7 p.m. as we continue our series, It Hits Different. Oh, and for any other information, maybe about Zoom times, or perhaps about any of the activities we mentioned, make sure to go to our email, youth@myrbconline.com. That's all, friends. Please follow us on Instagram to keep up with all things Res Youth at Res Youth Ministry. Until then, make sure to share God's word, share God's love, and share your walk.